Hello, Curious Minds. I'm Miles Maxcer, and welcome back to the Ant Network. I hope you're hungry. I hope your ants are hungry, because we are beginning a new series of videos to help you make sure that your ants are healthy and well-fed. In this episode, I'm going to cover carbohydrates, specifically honey water and sugar water. Ant keepers have many options, and just about everybody has a different opinion on what to feed their ants and how. Ultimately, it's up to you to do your research, experiment with your colonies, and determine what works best for them. In this series, I will be sharing my perspective, and I hope to leave you with at least the basic tools that you need to make sure that your ants are well fed. Many of the ant species commonly kept in captivity require sugars or carbohydrates to thrive. Worker ants get sugars in the environment by going to flowers, getting it from sap-sucking insects, and then sometimes even fruit. In captivity, we have many different options, including regular old table sugar, which is sucrose. We can use fruits, organic honey, and some ant keepers have even been able to keep live aphids and that they can provide to their ants, and they can have that awesome symbiotic relationship. But that's difficult to do, so most ant keepers will simply use honey water or sugar water. I usually use a ratio of one part sugar or organic honey to 2 to 3 parts of distilled or bottled water. You can boil the water to kill any microorganisms if you'd like. Use a clean container and a utensil and simply mix the sugar or honey into the water. Now, if you're having a hard time getting all of the particles to dissolve, you can actually cap it and give it a nice shake, and that seems to help whenever that happens. You can provide the honey water or sugar water to your ants in a number of different ways. Simply put some small droplets on a feeding dish, you can even soak a piece of apple in it, or you can use a dedicated liquid feeder. No matter what, you shouldn't be giving the ants large droplets because, let's face it, ants can be kind of clumsy, and if they fall in, they can get stuck and they can even drown in it. Another thing that you should be aware of is that as the water evaporates from the solution, the concentration of the solution is going to change, and the ants may be more or less receptive to it over time. Keep in mind that these homemade mixtures do not last long, and they should be removed within about 24 to 48 hours at most. You can always store excess solution in the fridge for a couple of days, or you can freeze it indefinitely. Be aware that while honey is antimicrobial, sugar water and honey water is not, so it can actually develop bacteria, mold, and other microorganisms in that solution. You should always test a new jar of honey on one colony or even just some tester workers that you pull from the environment. The reason being is that some honeys very rarely can contain something called miticide, otherwise said as miticide. Either way, it's a pesticide that helps control mites in honeybee colonies. And every once in a while, it seems like it works its way into the honey, and it can have deleterious or negative effects on your ant. So just make sure you test a new jar of honey. I always recommend that you go with organic because it usually indicates that there's less of a chance that pesticides might be in that honey. There's never a guarantee. Check it with your colonies. Scientific studies and experience from hobbyist ant keepers have shown that sucrose-only diets in captivity have been able to yield successful ant colonies, at least in terms of carbohydrates. Ants definitely still need separate protein sources. Other studies have also indicated, however, that ants tend to prefer aphid honeydew, which contains things like trisaccharides, also fructose, glucose, sucrose, amino acids, and other things. So we also know that what we're doing in captivity by giving them sugar water or even honey water, it's not a perfect replacement for what they are consuming in the wild. And it's very possible that our recommendations when it comes to ant nutrition will change over time as we do new studies and we learn new things. What I can tell you is that all of the recommendations in this video, in this series, even just on the Ant Network, have a sure footing in my experience, in the experience of other ant keepers, or in the experience of ant researchers. So we're not going to lead you astray. At least we certainly have tried very hard not to. Thanks so much for watching this video. Please make sure that you are subscribed and hit that bell icon. Over 60% of the people who watch the Ant Network's videos are not subscribed, and being subscribed to us really helps out our channel. Thanks so much for watching. Please stay safe, everybody, and I hope to see you here again soon.